What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a very exciting Liverpool video, because in this video I will be showing you guys all the new pictures of Liverpool FC's official new balance kit for the 2019-2020 season. So let me know, what do you think about the new kit? At the moment the home and the goalkeeper kit has been announced, that I absolutely love both of them. And let me know, if you pre-order the home kit, which number and which player will you get, or what name do you get on the back of your shirt? Let me know. And this official kit is paying homage to the legendary Liverpool manager Bob Paisley, who is the most successful manager in Liverpool's history. And this is the year of his 100th anniversary of his birth, so that's why we have a special kit, and this resembles a kit. And this is a very special tribute from Liverpool FC to Paisley's remarkable Liverpool FC legacy, which we will talk about later in this video. Each jersey is inscribed with his signature on the inside of the neck, and also includes a swing tag dedicated to his incredible achievements. And this is retaining the popular deeper red shade of recent years, which I absolutely love. You know, this year's kit and last year's kit already was a deeper red shade, which I really love, and I love wearing it. So this home shirt features stylish white pinstripes, this was inspired by the 82-83 campaign that saw Liverpool clinch a 14th league title in Paisley's final season at the helm. And talking about Liverpool kits, Liverpool FC are in talks with New Balance and also other big brands, as Liverpool are looking to strike the biggest and most lucrative kit deal in Liverpool's history, and in Premier League history as well. And the chief commercial officer of Liverpool FC, Billy Hogan, confirmed that discussions were on the way with New Balance, whose £45 million a season kit contract is ending next year. So in 2020 we will probably no longer be with New Balance, but there are rumors that we are in talks with Nike, with Adidas and other brands, and whoever offers the biggest pile of cash, the biggest, the most money, that's where Liverpool will go. And I will be honest, I really love the kits of New Balance, but I'm not sure if they can compete with the biggest brands in terms of the financial offerings, so we shall wait and see. But this is what the chief commercial officer said: we are in conversation with New Balance, and we are in conversation with other brands as well. The kit deal is an incredibly important partnership, not just for the financial support it delivers for the club, but also from the distribution standpoint as well. While it's always about the success on the pitch, it's also about ensuring we build really strong relationships, as you can't always count on the pitch performances, because the Premier League is such a competitive league. A partner invests with the club, and that investment is directly impacting what happens on the pitch. That revenue is then transferred into the opportunity to run the club and to invest in players. That's a benefit to us, but we need to be able to then deliver a benefit to that partner. So that comes through a shared understanding of what their business objectives are, and then how we can use the various mechanisms that we have to help deliver against that. And he continued, when you consider different categories, it might not seem like there's an exact fit with football or with sports, but actually when you start to think about what every organization is trying to do, it is to try and influence people's behavior, and ultimately we have an incredibly passionate and global fan base. When you look at the data, it will show Liverpool fans are more likely to support our partners because they see the support those partners are delivering to the football club. And that's just my comment. I think it makes a lot of sense, because if you see a brand already being supportive of your favorite club, you will choose that brand more likely or not. So just an example, if you are looking for a car tire and you have many top car tire manufacturers, but one of them supports Liverpool and they are in contract, and you know that that particular tire manufacturer is as good as the others and they also support Liverpool Football Club, why wouldn't you choose that tire manufacturer? But that's just an example off the top of my head, that it makes sense for Liverpool to branch out to a lot of different sponsors, because I think that will give, of course, the club a bigger chance to be successful on the pitch, because these sponsorship deals are very, very important for Liverpool FC, and we can invest more into the players, and that in turn results in a more success on the pitch, and that's what everybody wants ultimately. And this is a great cycle. So, and more success on the pitch equals more sponsorship opportunities, bigger contracts. Because now Liverpool can say that we are a potential Premier League title winner and a potential Champions League title contender club. And they can say to big brands, you need to pay as much as anybody who gets the biggest contracts. And according to the Liverpool Echo, they are claiming that the Liverpool are in advanced talks with Nike over an eye-watering deal that will exceed the £750 million contract that Manchester United currently have with Adidas, and that contract is for 10 years, so basically it is £75 million. Per season, which is huge. Man United's agreement is the most lucrative in British football at the moment, but Liverpool are reportedly in deep discussions with the American manufacturers to earn them the biggest contract in the Premier League. And Liverpool have never had a kit made by Nike, actually. They have previously worn the likes of Umbro, Adidas, Reebok, Warrior, before the new De Balance deal came into effect in 2015. It is reported, however, that New Balance have a matching clause within their contract which enables them to retain and extend their deal, by equaling any rival offer, which means that basically New Balance can offer as much as other brands offering, and they can retain Liverpool as the official partner. So yeah, let me know what you think about this. The 2017-2018 kit was the highest selling Liverpool kit of all time, and the current deal is worth £45 million per season, which is big, but it's £30 million less per season than the deal that Manchester United has. And it was such high demand for the last year's kit that Liverpool moved to establish a pre-order system, which was set up ahead of stock replenishments in October 2017 after the Liverpool strip sold out. So Liverpool fans were ordering so many kits, and I was one of the orders as well, because that kit was just gorgeous. That's my all-time favorite kit. And it was a really, really special anniversary kit as well, so I think it was worth the money. So I'm really hoping that Liverpool can find a really, really good partnership with a brand, and I don't really care which brand it is, I just want Liverpool to get the most money per season so we can invest that into players and be more successful on the pitch, because that's the most important in my opinion. And Bob Paisley won an absolute bucket load of trophies, that's why he is Liverpool's most successful manager, and he was a Liverpool player as well, but he won six league titles out of Liverpool's 18 league titles. That's one third of all the Liverpool league titles that Liverpool FC won in their entire history. He also won 3 league cups, which is almost half of the total of the league cups that Liverpool won. Liverpool won 7, and Bob Paisley won almost half of them. He won the Charity Shield 6 times as well, so it's incredible. And what is also, in my opinion, very, very significant is that he won 3 European Cups, that's the equivalent of winning 3 Champions Leagues, and no other English club actually has more than 3 Champions League trophies. So Bob Paisley won as many Champions Leagues as a Liverpool manager as Manchester United, the whole club. which is remarkable. He also won a UEFA Cup, so he won 4 European trophies, and he won a UEFA Super Cup as well, and that is incredible. And in every season that Bob Paisley was the Liverpool manager, Liverpool finished either first or second. He came second twice, and he came first 6 times. He came second in the FA Cup as well. That's the only big trophy that he couldn't win, the FA Cup. And the Intercontinental Cup, he finished second in that as well. He had a win percentage of 57.57%, which is incredible. He won 308 games out of the 535 games that he was the manager. And he was the Liverpool manager for only 9 years, but as you could see, he won like 18 or 19 trophies, which is absolutely crazy. So 6 league titles, 3 league cups, that's 9, 6 charity shields, that's 15 trophies, 3 European cups, that's 18, 1 UEFA Cup, 1 UEFA Super Cup. So in just 9 seasons, Bob Paisley won 20 trophies. Wow, and considering that Liverpool have in total about 48 trophies or something like that, to win 20 of them in just 9 years is a remarkable achievement. So hats off to Bob Paisley. He more than deserves a shirt dedicated to his memory, and I'm just really, really excited about this shirt, because this could have a golden Premier League badge on the side if Liverpool managed to win their first Premier League title. And also, we could have somehow 6 stars above the Liverpool badge, which would represent winning 6 Champions League trophies. So I think I will hold off on pre-ordering this shirt until after the season is finished, because I want to find out how many trophies Liverpool can win this season. I really hope that we can do the incredible double. It would be so, so good to win the Champions League and the Premier League in one season. But it's not a given. There is very, very big competition for Liverpool, but I really hope that Liverpool can do it, and then I can get a special shirt with a Premier League badge, a golden badge or something like that. If we win the Premier League, that would be just magnificent. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you later. Goodbye.